Before you design anything in Canva, stop. There are a few things you should never do on this platform, and well, you may be surprised by some of them. I'm Natalia, and I help you create better content and grow on social media, so let's do this. For all my content creators out there, stop removing backgrounds from your photos every single time you design something in Canva. It's a waste of time, and I'll show you exactly why. Instead of finding the photo, adding it to your design, removing the background, and waiting for it to happen, sometimes tweaking the results here and there, create a folder in Canva where you store all of your transparent PNGs with backgrounds already removed. All you have to do is to take a bit of time to add all your key brand photos, then remove all the backgrounds, clean them up, and then export them all at once. Then you can re-upload the files right into this new folder and then just add them to your creations with a click or two. It's such a time saver. And as a bonus tip, if you regularly use outlines, use shadows or textures under your cutouts, then by all means, add them before exporting too, so that you're saving yourself the hassle too. I'm all about efficiency, and this is such a great way to design faster in Canva. By the way, if you want to learn more tricks like this to speed things up, then watch this video next. And speaking of efficiency, if you consistently use the same visuals or designs for your brand, there are three ways in which Canva can help you save even more time. First, if you have any images, graphics, or icons that you use over and over again, then add them to your brand kit. It's so much easier to grab them from there instead of searching for them all the time. Next, if there's a design that you keep copying to recreate, like an Instagram carousel or a Reels cover, just save it as a brand template. Not only is it easier to recreate, but it's also super accessible from your brand kit so that you can quickly design with the right visuals. And the final Canva boss of repetitive visuals is using BookCreate. If you have a series with similar visuals that you consistently post on your social media, like a listicle post, for example, a tip series, or even a carousel, try generating multiple designs instantly by just populating the text and images quickly with BookCreate. I have a full tutorial on how to do it on my channel, but all you have to know now is that if done right, it's the perfect way to post more and save time. Mind you, all three of these features I mentioned in this point are Canva Pro only, so make sure to claim your free trial from the link below to test it out yourself for a whole month, try Pro elements and functions, and create templates for your brand, which, by the way, you'll be able to keep even if you don't stick to Pro, so I'm sure you're gonna love this. Now, you know how sometimes you need to change text on multiple pages, like an Instagram handle on a carousel template from the Canva library, or a brand name, for example? Well, don't manually adjust the text in the boxes one by one. Instead, simply go to File in the top left corner, choose Find and Replace Text here at the very bottom of the menu, then just type the text you want to replace and what you want to replace it with, of course, then hit replace all and you're done. It's super quick and gives you no hassle. There are thousands of Canva templates in the library and you can be easily sucked in trying to find that perfect one. Normally, people either jump into the design tab, scrolling to find something fitting, or use the search bar and do it this way. This is all fine, but it's also pretty limiting. What you want to do instead is to use the filter options from the templates panel. Not only does it help you search for different sizes, meaning that you're not missing amazing results only because you chose, say, an Instagram portrait post format, but it's also much more powerful due to all the filters that you can use. So let's say I want to create a square post for a skincare brand. I start with a search bar to get the keyword results, and they immediately show me all the different templates in here. I can then go to filters in here and then choose the specific style, the theme, even topic or color to get a much more tailored search. You can already see how it changed things. Let's say this is something that I like, even though it's a Reels template. No worries, I could either select all the elements from this template, including the background, and then paste it over my original Instagram post, and then tweak it just a little like that. Or I can use the magic resize button and shift it to the dimensions I want. Now you've got so many more options available and they're also much easier to find. Moving on, this is probably the biggest Canva mistake beginners make. You create a new design, find a cool looking template, change up the text, and sweet, you're done, right? Nah, it's really bad, like really, really bad. And it's the reason why Canva gets such a bad rap sometimes. You've got to make it your own. First, colors. Either go to your brand kit and apply your palette, or if you don't have Pro, pop your palette onto the editor, then right-click and choose Apply Colors to Page. Shuffle it as many times as you have to till it feels right. Next, we've got fonts. Again, if you've set up your brand kit, you can go to Design tab and apply your fonts with just a click. If not, then you need to change them up manually. You can also use the Change All feature if you have more than one text box with the same style. Okay, but what else? Look at the elements and see if they match the vibe of your brand. Do you consistently use any graphic elements? Swap the template once for these. Just a few quick tweaks and the template looks much more unique to you, and it's like we're keeping the structure but changing up the decorations. Now that you know this, stop using Canva templates as they come. Now, staying on the subject of keeping your brand consistent, how you communicate matters too. For those of you who use Canva AI to generate text, please hear me out. It's not enough to use Magic Write and just to prompt it to generate something for you. If you do this, it's likely going to spew something pretty generic, a little stiff sounding, or on the contrary, go all casual on you to the point that it doesn't even sound human. I'm sure you've all seen it happen before, and that's why we've got the brand voice options available in the brand kit. If you go to the homepage and pop over to the brand hub, then choose the kit that you want and scroll all the way down, you'll find this section right here, which helps you determine your brand voice. And it's so important because that's the difference between fake sounding, uncanny valley giving copy, and something resembling how you actually talk and write much more closely. Just like your visuals, your copy needs to match the style of your brand. Once you do have it set up, all you need to do is to go to the editor and pull up your brand kit from the left panel, and you'll see that you can generate text using your own brand tone. A little side note, as all AI generated text, you should always tweak it even further to really make it your own. I treat everything I generate with AI as just a jumpstart or a first draft. And for those creators who don't enjoy writing as much, it makes all the difference in the world to start from something that gives off a similar vibe than to start with text that sounds absolutely nothing like you. Now we've got efficiency, we've got consistency, but we have to talk about organization. If you've been using Canva for a while, chances are it's gotten a little messy over time, and I get it. Trust me, we've all been there, and it's a very common experience. This doesn't mean that we can let it go, though. There's so much to unpack here, and I actually have already unpacked it in this video right here. But if there's one thing I wish people would stop doing in Canva, it's using the uploads folder for everything. Usually when I say this, I get a little pushback because isn't that what the uploads folder is for? Yes, yes it is, but only when you're actively designing. Then it should all be filed away neatly into relevant folders that can be easily found and used again. What happens when you don't do it is this. You scroll and you scroll and you can't find that thing that you're pretty sure you've already uploaded. Then you get tired, you go to your desktop and find it and then upload it again. And inevitably, you end up with tons of duplicates and a whole lot of mess. So what's the alternative? This. All my brand photos easily accessible from this folder. On my products, right here. My thumbnails, my screenshots, my backgrounds, everything is organized so that I always know how to find each asset super quick. And my uploads folder looks like this. The only reason I keep these in here is because I use every single one of them every day to check the boundaries of my posts, the reels and reels covers. So if you have anything that you use absolutely every day, by all means, let it live in your uploads folder. Now, another thing I wish people stopped doing is not naming their designs. So pretty much, I wish they started naming them all. The second you create a new design and land in the editor, you should just quickly jump in here to the very top and rename it. One, you should say what it is. So anything that describes the design well, like morning skincare combo in this case. And two, I then like to add a category. So something like Instagram story for this one. The reason we want to do this is to always easily locate your designs, to grab stuff from them, to recreate them or repurpose them in full with just a quick search. Otherwise, you end up with a bunch of untitled designs and generic keyword stuff template titles that mean nothing to you. This is the second biggest reason why Canva accounts get so messy over time. Okay, we've got these covered. Now it's time to talk about more serious stuff, licensing, everyone's favorite topic. Now, as with any tool, you have to keep in line with the licensing terms of the platform, and it's super important in all cases, but especially if you use Canva for commercial purposes. I've seen so many Etsy listings with templates taken pretty much straight from the Canva library without modifying it much or frankly at all sometimes, and they're being sold as is, which is absolutely against the policies. Not only this, but it's violating Canva's rules, and it's also heavily infringing on the creator's copyright, and it's never okay. The thing is, some people don't read the licensing agreement at all. They hear that you can sell Canva templates and run with it without realizing they're doing something wrong. But this can lead to real life consequences. Your Etsy listings can be taken down and your account suspended, and you can face issues with your own Canva account as well, since these assets were improperly used. Now, this is just one tiny example of many, many others, and it's super important to know what you can and cannot do with the different parts of Canva and for what purpose. So the point here is to stop using Canva before you get to know the licensing terms. I'll leave some useful links for you down in the description, and I always advise, if in doubt, reach out to the Canva support team to learn what is allowed for your specific use case, and of course, get it in writing too. There's also a big part of this that we have to talk about, and it's actually creating logos in Canva. Now, I know that if you're a student working on a project, you maybe have a side hustle, or you're only just starting your business, you may need a decent looking logo and definitely don't have the need or the budget for a professionally designed logo and a well developed brand identity. Early days, it's absolutely normal. That's why I say sometimes Canva can be an easy tool to do so. But if these don't apply to you, I'd have to say Canva should not be used to create a logo. First and foremost, you cannot trademark a Canva created logo unless you designed it with something completely unique using basic shapes like lines, like circles, triangles, rectangles. You can also use fonts too. But anything going beyond that wouldn't be acceptable as a trademark, and you could also get in trouble because of it, because you don't own the copyright to every element of this logo. The original creator of this asset does. So here's a comparison. You always want to protect your brand, and registering a trademark plus owning the crucial assets that make your brand unique are almost always an essential step on the path to creating a serious business. Secondly, Canva is a great tool for creating content, but it's not professional software. It doesn't have the functions necessary to design something as important as a logo and some other elements of your brand visual identity. The main reason, among others really, is the fact that it cannot produce quality vectors. Vector graphic, as opposed to raster graphics, can be scaled without the loss of quality, which means you can blow it up on a billboard or cram it down on a pen, and both will look great. With raster graphics, think regular image format like JPEGs, for example, you simply cannot do it because it will pixelate and look horrible. Sure, we have the option to export as SVG in Canva. It's okay for web and some printing, for example, CryCut, I think, although I haven't used it myself, but it's not enough for professional printing. There is also the issue of uniqueness. Just take a look at this. Ultimately, your logo is only one piece of the bigger puzzle that is your brand. And if you're serious about your business, you'll want to have your whole brand identity and brand design created strategically by a professional brand designer at some point. Now, there are other things that I wouldn't necessarily recommend you create in Canva specifically, with conditions, of course, like websites, like CVs, newsletters, so much more. So if you'd like me to talk about it, then drop me a comment down below. I feel like it's so important to have your strategy figured out when you do anything, really both on and offline. And I'm confident that this video right here will help you build a strong one yourself. Plus, you can check out this video to design faster in Canva too. Subscribe and hit that like button. It helps me bring you more content consistently. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.